Hey guys, it is your afternoon host, Raquel Goldie. We're at Dare Day Club here at the Hard Rock in Hollywood, Florida, and I am here with Above and Beyond. What's going on, guys?
We're good. We just got in last night and just settling in, bit of jet lag and this lovely Miami breeze to wake us up.
I was gonna say you've got the
breeze. I mean Fort Lauderdale breeze, but yeah.
It's okay because most people have no clue that we're not in Miami. So the fact that you know, good job. You get a gold star today. All right. So you just announced yesterday that you were going to be going on your Acoustic 3 tour. Why do you think it's so important for you to kind of keep doing this acoustic tour?
People seem to like it. I mean, you've asked the right person. I absolutely love doing it. It's fun to do. It's an exciting process to take these existing songs and completely reimagine them, but borrow great chunks of records and bands and producers that you've liked in order to do that. So the process is nice. People seem to enjoy going to it. So, you know, it's one of those, it's another string to our bow, like the electronic music and like the yoga music that we do. It's nice to be able to change it up.
It's a little holiday from doing your day job, if you like.
I love it. And I saw that you guys were actually ending the tour in Colorado in Red Rocks. Is that your favorite venue?
That is a really great venue. I don't know if it's our favorite. There's so many amazing venues in the US especially, and it's hard to pick a favorite, but Red Rocks is special, isn't it?
It is. We'll know when we've played it. I mean, we do electronic shows, so you're not really sort of thinking about the feedback from the audience, but when you do the acoustic show, the sound of the audience is incredibly important. And that's why for me on the last tour, my favorite two shows were the ones we did at the Greek Theater in Berkeley in San Francisco, because it was loud. It was really loud. The way that the audience seats are arranged, it made it really loud for us. And so we'll see. We're playing a lot of places that we've not played before. Radio City Music Hall in New York, obviously a very famous place, and some other great theaters. So we'll see.
Do you prefer playing in some place like Radio City that's super famous and has all this history, or do you prefer playing a huge festival like Ultra that's coming up that you guys know very well? Which one do you kind of prefer? I mean, it's two very different situations, obviously.
It's one of those things, because it's only after you've done the show you really know, and I think it's really down to the audience. The venue is really important. It does create an atmosphere as well, but really it's about the people who are in there, and we don't know until we've done it, right?
No, that's true. I mean, before the show, often those old venues with a history are great fun to be in, because you can walk around, see all the photos of all the people who played there before, and realize how absurd it is that we're playing those places. It really is. I mean, especially, you know, you look at when we were backstage at the Hollywood Bowl, looking around some of the people who played there, you know, blows your mind that you get a chance to do something that can get in those places.
Now, I have to say, I listen to a lot of artist interviews. Obviously, we are a radio station. I'm on the radio. We interview a lot of DJs, producers, and a lot of them say that you are their inspiration. So how does that kind of, does that even like set in? How do you feel about that?
It's really sweet to hear that, but it's hard to know what to do with that, really. I mean, it's lovely.
They must be really young, the people you're talking to, I'm guessing.
We do everyone.
I don't know. I mean, yeah, I suppose my inspiration is not necessarily dance music, because that's not what I grew up with. But then when I was in my teens, I started to hear dance music. So it's interesting to think that people who are getting into this now have actually been inspired by other dance music, because that's quite different from Tony and I.
Yeah, there wasn't a great history of dance music to be inspired by when we started. Or maybe not that we'd noticed. Certainly not the kind of music that we were making. I think, you know, before the advent of trance, which we were pretty quick in getting on board with, most dance music was kind of more housey, and I guess I wasn't so much inspired to make that. It was only when I heard Robert Miles' Children that I thought, wow, this is music that I think maybe I'd be interested in trying to make being the octave work.
we're still learning, you know. So
I was gonna say, I feel like everyone's still kind of learning, and the industry and the genre is always evolving. So do you ever see yourself steering away from the kind of music you make and kind of completely rebranding?
Well, I think that's what the acoustic project's all about, really, and also, you know, the yoga album, things like that. We do other projects in order to keep it fresh. And when you come back to dance music, you then inevitably bring in some of those little ideas and or just simply have a fresh perspective on it, because if you do the same thing over and over again, it does get boring, and so you need to refresh your mind and take a break sometimes, and yeah, doing some other kinds of music is a good way of doing that.
All right, so Ultra Music Festival is a month and a half away. It's like the mecca of South Florida, Miami, everything that it could possibly want it to be, it is. Do you have any surprises?
Not yet.
Not yet.
I'm looking at him thinking.
I don't want surprises for other South Florida, Miami residents. It's, I'm a temporary and sometime resident of Miami. I've got a flat in Midtown. Which gets me a discount on Miami Golf Course, Miami Beach Golf Course. I get residence discounts. So I'm officially a resident of Miami, which is really nice. It's a really nice up and coming area. The security man at the airport said, "You live in Midtown." That's kind of, it's kind of grim there, isn't it? I was like, not for the last 15 years, maybe. So you know, I count myself as one of you locals now.
I love it. That's the surprise we got.
A little Easter egg for you, you know?
Yeah. We're a local band. A little pebble that I get. All right, guys, thank you so much for sitting down with us. I have to ask one last question. What is your favorite Miami memory? A lot of times we ask that question and people are like, "Ooh, can't tell you," because we've had some rough ones. But I feel like you guys have got a nice, wholesome one.
The first thing that sprung to mind, actually, for me, was one of the first times we came here. We played in this club called Bed. I don't know if you know that club. I think it's closed now. But it was a tiny club, and I just remember having an amazing gig there. But there's nothing specifically exciting about that other than it being a really nice gig. But I don't know. Have you got one?
I mean, aside from when it rained at Ultra and all of our equipment broke, and there was no umbrellas or any rainproofing for this rainstorm that was 6 hours in the making. That was a low light for me, but I think my favourite memory is when we played at the Bayfront Amphitheatre. I always remember we played after Matt Zoe, and he played on a bit longer than he should have done. But it's such a great venue because you can see everybody. You can literally see everybody's face, and that for any kind of performer, whether you're reading poetry or acting or playing in a band, to actually be able to see everybody's face is great, rather than it just being a sort of dark place. And I really miss that venue. It's a shame that they don't play there anymore. But
all right, guys, well, thank you so much for sitting down with us. We will see you very soon now that we know you are a resident.
Yeah, yeah.
Come on, stop by the station whenever you want. We're actually in Wynwood, so we're super close.
Oh, I will. I will. Yeah, that's, well, I'm Midtown, so you know, just
you can come do my show with me.
I'm virtually a resident in Sugarcane, the restaurant. I love it in there. Brussels sprouts, yes.
Now we know we're going to just hang out with you all the time. All right, guys, what is your social media? Go ahead, plug it in so everyone can follow you, stay updated with the acoustic tour.
At Above and Beyond on Instagram, Twitter, and I guess there's a slash before it on Facebook. So there you go.
Easy enough. All right, guys, we will catch you all next time. Bye.